the most important lesson is that to be a photonics designer, right, means to embrace a dual identity. And I think dual at the minimum. They need to start thinking of themselves both as a device scientist and as a circuit designer. That's what photonics design really means. It's a discipline, it's a field. It's a field of inquiry that's still very young.
The AIM Photonics Academy hosted their third week-long boot camp-style session recently on the campus of MIT. Close to 60 participants from all over the world attended to find out more about the fundamentals and design practices of the photonic integrated circuit industry.
The AIM Photonics Institute actually is unique in that it has its own factory already, about $1 billion worth of investment in a foundry to produce these integrated photonics chips, as well as another investment about half as large that does packaging and testing and assembly of these into small modular systems. We have the capability to now make these things. Now we have to learn how to design them, how to design for the application, and this is what we're teaching these students.
The design track is new to the boot camp and teaches the students to design and take advantage of the automated design infrastructure already in place within the semiconductor industry.
And if they can use those tools, then they're way ahead in producing new designs and replicating those designs and scaling forward.
I've been working primarily with Synopsys software to basically make layouts for chips, and it's really useful in my job because we use those layouts and we fabricate devices from the wafer level up. So I've been primarily making waveguides and lithium niobate for Mach-Zehnder modulators and also photonic integrated circuits. So it's really useful to me to have that information, to have that skill set so that I'm able to implement that.
The fundamental track teaches how to do the processing and design and how to implement total quality management.
The focus and the maturity of the focus on manufacturing is really welcome, because it's often in academic and environments where there's a focus on the theory or the how to produce one, or we got results from a sample size of two, that it's only the very beginning of a technology when you think that way. But it's also very common. Being an industrial person, being an industry and an engineering person, the understanding that there is inherent process variation and how it affects the products, which has been a fairly significant topic the last couple of days, is surprising and very interesting to me.
There are a number of courses where people get trained in devices, in circuit modeling, and in thinking in very concrete terms about the application's payoff for the real world, right? So this is a very, very engineering-focused payoff that the program has.
We want them to understand what the challenge is in creating what we call new S-curves for this technology. Everybody gets a new idea, and then we pile in everybody's new innovations, and we start a ramp of exponential growth in the industry.
The AIM Photonics Summer Academy brought together students from small and medium enterprises, providing practical access and technology on-ramps for U.S. industry, government, and academia.
Well, it's MIT, and so they know how to teach you. They know the different things that are important, things that are at the frontier. They're also bringing very interesting people together, people who can make tools, people from big companies, small companies. They're putting them in teams. It's very practical education. Not only are we learning from the best, and there are not that many people who really understand the field or have knowledge of all the technical detail, and it's a very unique opportunity that they've been able to bring that many people from around the country to talk about what they have learned and what they have seen.
The AIM Photonics Summer Academy introduced attendees to the prerequisite skill set needed to complete AIM's online training course, which will be offered in the fall for design submissions to the multi-project wafer prototype runs at the AIM Photonics Institute's fabrication facility. Reporting for Photonics Media and Light Matters, I'm Autumn Pilant.